Are you concerned about your teenager's eating habits or perhaps failure to eat? Dr. Lewis first answers parents' questions about the serious topic of eating disorders.
Parents have been feeding me lots of questions, even in the kitchen, about whether or not their teenager might be developing signs of an eating disorder. Well, let me see if I can digest some information that's helpful to everyone on this serious problem. Eating disorders represent negative thoughts and feelings about body weight and about food. Teenage girls can develop this problem, but also teenage guys. And it comes in usually two different types. There's anorexia nervosa, which is a fear of putting the pounds on with a negative, misperceived body image. And there's bulimia, where someone takes in large amounts of food, binges, only to have that food removed by self-induced vomiting or use of laxatives to lose weight. What causes an eating disorder? We're not sure. We think it's multifactorial. It might be genetic, there might be family and social factors, might even be due to psychological or traumatic stress. How can you tell if your teenager is coming down with an eating disorder? Well, they're probably going to be preoccupied with food. They'll be in the kitchen a lot talking about foods they can and can't eat. They're worried that they need to lose even more weight and are losing weight excessively. They're on and off the scale and they're exercising rigorously. As for bulimia, you may find that your child is making excuses to use the bathroom after every meal, tends to be complaining about how much weight they need to lose, and again, you find laxatives in the bathroom or around their room. If you suspect an eating disorder, you need to seek medical attention as soon as possible, because the sooner you get your child seen by a doctor, the better the outcome. Untreated, eating disorders can go on to cause dehydration, kidney disease, heart disease, malnutrition, and even death. What does treatment involve? It involves extensive medical care, as well as psychological and nutritional counseling, and sometimes even hospitalization. And parents, you need to be good role models too. Don't complain that you need to lose weight in front of your children, but instead promote healthy lifestyles and promote your teenager's self-confidence and self-esteem so they're less apt to develop the symptoms and signs of an eating disorder. So that hopefully, tips like this will weigh well with you, and in turn with your teenagers, when it comes to knowing more about how to prevent eating disorders. This is pediatrician Dr. Lewis First from Vermont Children's Hospital, Fletcher Allen, reminding you to always be first with your kids.